And today I start with an experiment. I have made this. And the work was quite interesting and long. This time I would like to have a lot of very detailed videos about the work. So I decided to do more than one video in order to let you understand my way to do things. One, two, maybe three or four videos to arrive at this point. I will publish the videos one after another, perhaps 2 days between one video and the other. Hope you appreciate. Let me know in the comments. Hello everyone and welcome to the channel once again for a new project. Today we start the work to get this car on the track. I think that I will start from the back. Fortunately, I found at home in a tiny box in the background of the shelf these two satellites that were missing. Inside, there's a surprise, the battery holder from a friend of mine. He's from Belgium and I made a video to thank him for this great help. You see, the back part of the car is made just to have the wheels mounted, but I don't have the engine. And I will use this 540 with this support. It is not the real support, but it fits quite good. The dip has to be mounted by this side. There's a lot to do, and no more bubbles, no more walls. If these are bashing, they work very well. No more walls, and let's start the work. Comment, like, and subscribe. Thank you. Ball bearings in front, I don't think. And now we can mount the diff as it has to be mounted. We start the rear shaft, the rear transmission assembling with this wonderful, very professional, quite dirt white gloves. Gloves are necessary in order not to leave your fingerprints on the metal, because sometimes our skin is quite acid and you leave signs and then could become rusty. So gloves are important. They say washer, self-tapping nut, tied up, later I do with the tool, then wheel, inside the wheel, this by this way, then between this and this one here inside, like this, then the gear with the satellite
Hope they don't fall down. Okay. Then the opposite one. Then we can mount this. That stops. This is a stopper for the. Okay. Then you have to push here inside in order to have the right play. Then push a little bit here. And if you want a hard differential, you push more. If you want a free differential, you push less. Then you stop with this Allen screw. If I found the hole. Okay. Not so free. I like this. The car is a little bit understeering, but starts faster. Then we can put this into the support, as I told you. Nice surprise. It has ball bearings. And you can see easily. Curiosity, left and right. Remember, left and right on cars is always referring to the driver. So even if the driver is seated here or here, his right arm is always by the same side. Okay, then we have to put this stopper by this part. And here you have to pay attention because you have to leave a little bit of play. Otherwise, it doesn't turn. Okay. Too much. Okay. Then this other tire, and now this is quite difficult. Okay, perhaps. Okay, and this is a tip for you. The nut mounted on the magnet, strong magnet, then you go inside and turn. Okay, and you finish with the drill. One and the other one too. Okay. Now the engine. The engine mount that I have is a little bit different from the original one. It has these four holes that are for screws. The screw tights into this hole. And the original one has these two screws. And here there's a space for the nut on the other side. Okay, please don't tell to collectors, but I mount this using these two screws as other two screws. Fortunately, they measure the distance between the holes is perfect. Okay, the two front screws are in place, perfect, super tight, super stable, and with a little bit of thread liquid, this, I use this. And now for the back. For the back, I don't have this kind of screws. The old one with a straight cut, terrible screws. So they are not so necessary. I prefer not to put screws. Perhaps I have something. I don't want to use modern. I have all this, and here inside there's nothing can fit in the style of those screws. And this thing to me looks important. So I prefer to wait. Perhaps I have in another place old screws with a straight cut. Okay, by now the engine is mounted like this. Allez, voilà. After a very good and deep wash, test, and cables welded very well, the engine is on. But we have a problem, because the old man that is speaking to you has not the pinion I left in my other workshop. So by now we have just the engine. Next. Fantastic. Really. The servo moves a little bit. Quack, quack, quack. And now this thing.
So, and for today, this is all. You have seen the first steps. I made a lot of things and up to the next 2 days. Bye.